What year never makes you rich? Your money management strategy makes you rich. If what you earn makes you rich, a lot of these celebrities will be very rich and influential. But what happened? They eat a lot of money and in a few short years, they went broke. In today's video, I'll be sharing with you two very simple money management strategies that you can begin implementing today and to help you become rich in the least amount of time. Will you not like to be financially secure? Welcome back. If you are new here, I'm your host Akeem at DBC, and this is another episode of Common Sense Philosophy, where we'll be discussing the money management strategy to make you rich and secure your financial freedom. At the end of this video, you know clearly what money management strategy is and how you can begin using a profitable and effective money management strategy without having to starve or look cheap. A lot of lottery winners, when asked why they became broke after they eat such huge amount of money, they replied the money was so much they thought it will never finish. This is one of the biggest mistakes you can make in managing your money. Thinking your stream of income will continue the same way consistently. So, whether you earn hundreds of dollars, thousands of dollars, hundreds of thousands, or even millions, you need an effective money management strategy. So what are the money management systems that you can use? What are the money management strategies that you can use and begin implementing today? I'm going to be sharing you two. And at the end of this video, I will be sharing you one missing ingredient that a lot of people that talk about money management system don't talk about. In the book, The Secret of a Millionaire's Mind, Tiavaka broke a key secret for making yourself rich. In this system, he mentioned that you're going to need 6 different accounts where you're going to be dividing up your income. The accounts are FFE, LTSS, expenses, play, giving, education. Great. The FFE account, the financial freedom account, this is the account where you put part of your money. He recommends 10%, or you can change it up. This financial freedom account is to help you gather enough money, gather enough seed coin to invest and help replace your active income. He stressed that when you have enough money in your investment that pays you passively, whether you work or not, you can easily retire, you can afford better luxury like you always want, and also, you don't have to continue to work all your life. I already made a video about 5 profitable places, 5 profitable areas you can put your money, you can invest your money that people don't talk about. These profitable areas, you just need to check it out. Just click on the link above to watch the video, of course, after this. And I will also leave a link down in the description below. The second account on the list is your long-term savings for spending. If you earn $100,000 a year and there are items you want to pay for that are up to $80,000 or $100,000, you don't have to starve yourself to death before you procure such an item. You simply have to build a long-term savings for spending account where you put in a fraction of your income every time your income drops. So, to buy that car, to buy the house, to go on a vacation, or one of those things that you've been eyeing for a while, simply create an account dedicated to saving up the money to do what you need to do. Great. I do hope you've been getting value from this video. If so, remember to give me a thumbs up, drop a comment, and if you haven't subscribed, subscribe now so that you won't miss out on great content that I have in store for you. So, the third account Tiavaka spoke about is your education account. This is the account that will finance your online courses, books, seminars, and every other thing that you do that needs money. For example, here at Common Sense Philosophy, we help you with personal development tips, tricks, mindset, and strategies that will help you become better. That is a form of education. For such purposes, you need an account to fuel such expenses. A lot of us, when you take your paycheck, you are so busy saving for this, investing this and that, that you fail to enjoy life. And what do? After a while, you self-sabotage yourself and you destroy all the income. So in order to prevent that, you need a play account. This is an account that you use to nourish yourself. Use it to buy that expensive watch. Use it to go on a vacation. Use it to visit a restaurant, you know. Any of those things that nourish your soul, that helps you feel good about yourself, you need a play account. The other account you spoke about is a giving account. One of the prosperity secrets of the ages is when you give, you receive. This is the account where every money in it, you put it into charity. You put it into helping others in order to put that law in motion. The law of giving and receiving. Last but not the least in the Tiaveka's money management system is your expenses, which he recommends not more than 50% of what you earn. Oh no. I know some of you are already thinking, how can I survive on that? Well, that is why I'm talking about the second money management strategy, which is a money management strategy talked about in the book, The Richest Man in Babylon. In this book, The Richest Man in Babylon, one of the core advices for you to be rich, for you to be financially free, is to have an account whereby you put 10% of everything you earn, whether you earn weekly, whether you earn monthly, whether you earn yearly, anyhow you earn, put 10% of your income in this account. This money management strategy is not about saving your money to becoming a millionaire. No, you are saving up so as to gather enough pool of funds to invest. You may be asking, what if I have a debt to pay? What if I have something to buy? Then you need to set up another account, which is for the debt or for that thing you want to buy. The first missing ingredient to help you with this money management strategy is every time you receive an income, or once you are expecting an income, take a book and a biro and write down the amount. This is how much you're expecting. 10% of it, which is going to your savings. How much is it? Write it out in figure. The second thing that a lot of people miss when implementing money management strategy is being consistent. A money management strategy is a plan. Your plan doesn't give you results until you are consistent with it and you follow through. So, one of the major key missing ingredients that people don't talk about when we're talking about money management system is consistency. Whether you want to use the 10% or you want to use the Tiaveka's CISDAR system or any other one I have not mentioned, you need to be consistent. You may start with saving 2% of your money or 5%, then gradually take it up. I've also made another video to help you become consistent on your money management strategy and on your savings, which I'll leave a link somewhere up and also in the description below. Thank you for making it this far. I do hope you've been getting tremendous value from this video. If you've not subscribed, subscribe now. I release a video every week to help you with your personal development, to help you achieve the best results in all areas of your life. I'm your host, Akeem at DBC. Have a comment or something you'd like me to talk on next? Drop it down in the comments below. I will read and respond. And I leave you with this. Thank you for watching. Thank you for staying to the end. I've been your host, Akeem at DBC, and it's been Common Sense Philosophy. At Common Sense Philosophy, we believe no obstacles, no limits to your greatness or the obstacles you set for yourself. We at Common Sense Philosophy are to help you remove those obstacles so that you can be the best you were born to be. Until next time, until next Wednesday, bye-bye.